Hello and welcome to this session. Today we are going to learn some very basic Python programming, and that is classes and functions. And we are going to go very basic step by step and learn how to create classes, how to create functions, how to create objects for the classes, and some basic functions. Now, if you are completely new to Python, do not worry. It is very, very easy. And in a moment, I will show you how easy Python can be. So I will go to my PyCharm and I will create a new Python file. So I will do a right click, go to new and Python file. And I will name this as class function demo. And here, now to create a class, the keyword that we use in Python is class, and then we give the name for the class. So I will give any name. You can say my class and a colon, and then you press enter, and then you can see there is a space here, or there are five spaces. So basically this is a tab space, and whatever you write inside here will be a part of the class. So now you can give any property. For example, I declare name equals, I can say Raghav. So the name is now a property of my class. And now if you have to access the class or its property or create an object, the simple thing is you will say my class, and that's it. And you can also store this into a variable. So I say x equals my class. Now I can use x to access any of its properties. So you can see it is already giving us the name option. I will say name, so this will access name. And to print this, I will say print x.name. And if I run this now, I will do a right click and run class function demo. You can see it is printing Raghav. And you can also create functions inside a class. And to create a function, we use the keyword def, which is def, and give the function name and then brackets, and you will see it auto completes and provides a argument called self here. So self is a variable in Python which is used as the very first parameter or very first argument for every function. So every function will have self as the very first argument. Now it is not necessary to name it as self. You can name it as anything. I can say this is myself or anything. So this is not necessary to name it self, but it will always be the very first argument. And then you can give other arguments. For example, I say here a, b, and inside the function I say print a plus b. Now here I have already provided a variable x, which is a reference for my class. So now I can use x and I can call the function sum, and you can see it is here, and I can say 5, 4, 5. So it should give 4 to a and 5 to b, and then it should print a plus b, which should be 9. So if I print this now, I do not have to print this because there is already a print statement inside the function. So if I run this now, you can see it is printing 9 here. So this is very easy. And of course you can give a single quote also here, that should also work in Python. And also you can see how flexible it is. We are not giving like semicolons at the end like in Java and other strict programming languages, and it is very easy to create. Now the other very important thing you should always take note of: in Python every class has an inbuilt function which is called init, and it is double underscore init double underscore. This is a built-in function which is always present, and you can also explicitly define it. For example, I say def and double underscore init, you will also get this auto completion. And here this is by default called, but you can also parameterize it. For example, I say here name and age, and inside the function I say self dot name equals to name, whatever will come here, and self dot age equals age. So the use here is, now because this is the very first function which is called whenever a object is created for the class, now whenever you will create an object, you will have to provide name and age. So in your programming or during creation of frameworks, whenever you want to assign some values to some variables or some properties, as soon as an object is created, you can create a function init and then define all these things here. So now if I run this now, you will see an error. So let me run this now. So did you see an error here? So this is because whenever we create an object, so here we are creating an object for my class, and whenever we create an object, init is called, and you can see init has two arguments, but we are not passing any arguments here. So that is the reason it is throwing an error. So now we have to, whenever we create a class, we have to pass these two arguments. So let us say in the name I pass John and age I pass 40, and then I can now access this as well. I can say x.name here, and let me print this. Or we are also already printing name. So let me show you what will happen now. I will not do this. It is the same program, and let me run this now. Let us see what happens. So did you see it is not printing Raghav, it is printing John. Although we have initialized name with Raghav here, but because while creating an object for the class, init is the function which is always called, and here we are passing John. So that is why the name is now changed with John, or John is the value for name. And also you can print age. So for age you can say x dot age, and you can run this, and it is printing 40. Another very good thing you in Python is you can actually delete the reference of the object. So if I say delete x, it will delete the object reference x. And if I run this now, you can see nothing changed. It is still showing us the same result because we are deleting x after we are printing and doing all the operations. So if I take it from here, and if I take it before printing the age and I say delete x, now let us see what happens. I will run this, and you can see it printed John, it printed the sum 9, but when it came here it deleted x, and then when we tried accessing age with x, it did not find it, and therefore it threw an error. The other important thing is you can also delete some particular property or reference. So I am saying delete x dot name, and let us run this now. And now you can see it is showing us all the results because we are deleting name here, but age is still there, and we are printing age here. So age is still there, and we can get the result here. So this is a very simple way how you can use classes, functions and objects in Python. All these concepts will be used when we will start creating scripts and frameworks for Selenium. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.